The wait-and-see period is well and truly over. A torrent of international condemnation is being hurled at US President Donald Trump. Angela Merkel, perhaps his most powerful critic of all.
The battle against terrorism does not justify putting groups of certain belief under general suspicion, in this case people of Muslim belief or of a certain descent. This act runs contrary to the basic principles of international refugee assistance and international cooperation.
On Friday, British Prime Minister Theresa May left Washington gleaming. The first foreign leader to the White House, she appeared to have bridged a gaping transatlantic gap. Hours later, the US president sprung a surprise that may have undone much of that goodwill.
Totally, it's not a Muslim ban, but we're totally prepared. It's working out very nicely.
The rift is more than ideological. The US ban on entry for citizens from seven Muslim-majority countries could affect Britons and Europeans with dual nationality, including Omid Nuripur, a German MP with Iranian citizenship. Nuripur is vice chair of Parliament's German-US friendship group.
What Trump has done there now has nothing to do with security. If it were a matter of security, he would have to look at where the 9/11 attackers came from, for example. These countries are not all affected, one would assume, because Trump has a great deal of business with these countries.
In Brussels, the European Commission has joined the chorus.
This is the European Union. And in the European Union, we do not discriminate on the basis of nationality, race, or religion. Not only when it comes to asylum, but in any of our other policies.
The criticism hasn't been universal. Far-right leaders from Germany to the Netherlands have praised Trump's move. They'll be hoping that the US electoral upset can be repeated here this year. What's not yet clear is what their growing number of supporters might make of this latest reality of a populist in power. Guy Henderson, CGTN, Berlin.